In this video, we will discuss our GMAT-based reading comprehension. We will also take up one question based on central idea understanding. So let us start with the central ideas first. How many really suffer as a result of labor market problems? This is one of the most critical yet contentious social policy questions. In many ways, our social statistics exaggerate the degree of hardship. Right. So, reading these lines, what I can understand is that we are talking about labor market problems and stats acting as exaggeration of exaggerators of hardship, right? Okay. So, that is the start. Now, unemployment does not have the similar difficult tough consequences as in 1930s, because the unemployed were primary breadwinners. Right, and the margin of subsistence was very less. I mean, you just could just earn good enough to be sustaining yourself, and there were no other countervailing programs for those who failed. But increasing richness, the rise of families with more than one wage earner, and the predominance of secondary earners among the employed, and improved social welfare protection have definitely lowered the effects of joblessness. And the earning and income data, they overstate the dimensions of hardships. So it's given that many with hourly earning at or below the minimum wage level, most of them are multiple earning families people, right? And most of them, the counted by statistics, are either people who are elderly or handicapped, and which is not a correct indicator of labor market problems. So here the paragraph is about labor market problems. The fact that stats aggravates or overstates hardships, and there are certain things given here that, for example, multiple earners are there now, and also that the fact that there is a better social protection. So these things are the reasons why the author says that there is the hardships are overstated. So there were many points, so it just went a bit more, approximately 10 words. But ideally, as I always say, I look for 8 words, but if required, it can go a bit more. So this is the first para central idea. Let's go to para 2. Yet there are many ways of our, many ways social statistics underestimate. Okay, so this is the other side, the degree of labor market related hardship. Right. So here, now we are talking about the other side, how the stats underestimate. Right. Okay. Right. So let's continue. Low wages and prolonged unemployment frequently interact to undermine capacity for self-support, since the number of experiences joblessness at some time is several times the number unemployed in any month. Those who suffer as the result of forced idleness can equal or exceed average annual unemployment. And even though a minority of the in a month really suffer. So basically here there is a point that there can be idleness. So at a point of time, you might be getting that only these many people are unemployed, but then those people might be unemployed at some other time. So that varies, right? Further, for every person counted in the monthly unemployment tallies, there is someone working part-time also, because there is no full-time work, right? And or somebody who is wanting a job. And finally, the income transfer. So, okay. So here it is saying also about that there are some of the workers who are part-timers. So they don't get enough money and all. And further, it also says that income transfers protection is for the, not for the people who are working but getting less. Protection is usually for the elderly, etc. So, or the disabled. So these people are not getting the proper adequate protection. That is what the point is. So this paragraph is now talking about the hardships are real. The first paragraph said that the hardships are overstated because of the reasons. The second paragraph talks about that, no, they are actually underestimated because of the given reasons. So coming to the last paragraph, there is contradictory evidence, and it is uncertain whether those suffering seriously are the numbers. There are hundreds of thousands or tens of millions. So we are not sure. And we don't know thereby whether this can be tolerated or there should be job creation and economic stimulus. But there is one area of agreement in this debate, that these statistics are inadequate, right? So the point what the author is saying here is that there is contradictory evidence to the levels of hardships because of unemployment or poverty, etc. And as a result, one thing is for clear, that the statistics are inadequate. That is what the point is, to finally conclude this discussion. So let us run through the central ideas once again. The first paragraph talks about the labor market problems and says that perhaps the stats overstate hardship because there are multiple earners and there is social protection. The second paragraph talks about that actually the hardships are underestimated. So this hardship thing is clear here, but I'm still writing it down. Hardships are underestimated because there are people who are idle or who are doing part-time job, and the protection is usually for elders, not elders or disabled, not for the working poor. So that is the reason. Now, since there are contradictory evidence, this statistics is inadequate an indicator for understanding unemployment and joblessness, etc., and to understand what economic policies should be made. These statistics are inadequate. So that is the conclusion. Right. So now in this particular analysis, I'll be doing the question as well with you on central ideas. So which of the following is the principal topic of the passage, right? Which is basically it means the main theme. All right. What causes, option A, what causes labor market pathologies that results in suffering, which means looking after reasons. So that is not the main theme. The main theme here, what is the main theme? We are talking about that the stats are inadequate because of contradictory evidence, right? So the reasons is not the main theme. Reasons is not the main theme. That is what I would say. So I'm evaluating every option, whether it is the main theme or not. Okay. Why income measures are imprecise in measuring degrees of poverty. Now, again, this is not correct because this is not just about income measures and degree of poverty. It's not about that. So this is not the appropriate thing. We are talking about social statistics and we are talking about employment, economy, all those things, not just income measures and degree of poverty. Okay, now mercy, where the areas of agreement are among poverty, the areas of agreement. So areas of agreement is just a small part in the end. It's not the whole. That's just a small part, right? So it is not the main theme. Again, not the main theme. Okay, moving on. So the last one should be the correct one. The hint, I have that hint already, but let me just check it once again. D, how social statistics give an unclear picture of the degree of hardship caused by low wages and insufficient employment opportunities. Yes, this is the closest to what this paragraph is. So if I do central ideas properly, I'll be looking for those things, right? We are talking here about social statistics, right? We are also talking here about the unclarity, right? Unclear picture of the degree of hardship, right? And yes, we are talking about wages and employment opportunities. So if you read it properly, you will be able to actually identify answer to these questions very easily and look for the precision, the specificity in the given options and accordingly choose your answer. I hope this exercise helps you in many different types of theme-based or central idea-based questions. Understand if you read properly, writing down the central ideas in the way we are learning, you will be able to tackle these questions with ease. Thank you.